SOMED, Cervical Cancer Prevention Awareness and Health Matters. Your partner in Health Matters. Dedicated to promoting awareness of both male and female issues.
Hello everyone, my name is Edna Dapa and welcome to my channel. Today, I will continue the discussion on abnormal bleeding, inclusive of some aspects that will reference children. The information I'm about to deliver will support parents and carers as they look after the young ones. The awareness and knowledge that will be imparted on parents will put them in the position to abat any potential danger that may pose a threat to the health of their children. As we continue this series of abnormal vaginal bleeding, we will begin to realize that the condition is not really a death sentence. Various reasons that are easily resolved are most times responsible for abnormal vaginal bleeding. Today, I will be speaking about two processes or agents that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding. They are foreign objects in the vagina and uterine fibroid. Any object placed inside the vagina is called a vaginal foreign body. Such objects include tampon, birth control devices, sex toys, hair pins, buttons, seats, toy packs, forgotten pessaries, pen caps, toilet tissues, and illicit drugs. Some of the objects inserted in the vagina are not designed for it. The objects found in the vaginas differ amongst age groups. Toys, tissue papers, and clothing materials are quite common in children. Foreign objects found in the vagina of adults include tampons, condoms, and items used for sexual gratification. In the elderly, medical devices such as pessaries are noted. Prisoners and drug traffickers may use the vaginal canal to hide illicit substances. Some objects such as tampon, vaginal suppositories, and some medications are designed for use in the vagina. Others are not and may be inserted accidentally or intentionally. Vaginal foreign bodies are more commonly seen in children than adult women. The most common foreign body of the vagina in children is small amounts of fibrous materials from clothing, toilet paper, and carpets. During self-exploration, children may place foreign objects in the vagina, and these may be forgotten or unable to be removed by the child. Such objects are generally small and include marker caps or crayons. Children will generally not place objects larger than the vaginal entrance due to discomfort. Vaginal foreign bodies associated with adolescents primarily consist of forgotten tampons or broken portions of condoms. Occasionally, these tampons are forgotten and may not be removed for days. The breakage of a condom may also result in bits of latex or non-latex materials being left in the vagina. In adults, vaginal foreign objects may have been placed in the vagina intentionally as part of a sexual encounter or placed as part of an episode of abuse. On rare occasions, unusual objects may be placed in the vagina as the result of altered mental status. The presence of a vaginal foreign body could alter the normal bacterial flora of the vagina by changing its usual acidic environment. These foreign bodies stimulate the vaginal mucosa to produce more secretions, giving rise to increased vaginal discharge. Discharge often becomes smelly, blood-stained, and infected in the course of time and could flow out as abnormal vaginal bleeding. Vaginal foreign bodies could get stuck or left in the vagina and may subsequently cause symptoms such as a light vaginal bleeding, vaginal discharge that might be bloodstained, and foul smelling. Other symptoms of vaginal foreign bodies include itching, burning, redness, swelling, or rash near the vagina. Abnormal pain, fever, frequent urination, and in most cases, the symptoms go away once the object is taken out. In rare cases, an object can break through the walls of the vagina and cause an awful bad infection. Some females may be able to remove the foreign body themselves by simply placing their fingers in the vagina, locating and removing the object. Others may need to be removed by a healthcare professional. Affected persons may self-report a foreign body in the vagina or may present with an array of symptoms. The most common symptom is bloodstained, foul smelly vaginal discharge and vaginal bleeding. Small objects inserted into the vagina do not generally cause pain. Unusual objects that are larger than the vagina or with sharp edges may cause pain because of the swelling or enlargement they trigger. Another condition that could cause abnormal vagina bleeding is uterine fibroid. These are non-cancerous muscular growths that develop in the uterus and often appears during childbearing years. The condition is common in women ages 18 and 35 and affects up to 80% of women before the age of 50. Uterine fibroids are most common benign uterine and pelvic tumor in women. Fibroids may occur as a single growth or a group, and each can be as small as less than an inch or as large as 8 inches or even more. Many women are unaware they have fibroids because the condition could be non-symptomatic. The cause of fibroid is unknown, but they are under estrogen and progesterone hormonal control. They grow rapidly during a pregnancy when estrogen and progesterone levels are high. And they also stop growing or shrink once menopause is reached. In rare cases, complications caused by fibroid can affect pregnancy or cause miscarriage or infertility. In some instances, women with fibroid may be anemic because of heavy menstrual bleeding. There are factors that can increase the risk of developing fibroid. Fibroids are more common in women ages 30 and 40s, and after menopause, fibroid usually shrinks. Family history is also a factor, as having a family member with the condition increases the risk of having a fibroid. Ethnic origin plays a role, as African American women are more likely to develop fibroid than a white woman. Obesity is also a risk factor, as women who are overweight are at a higher risk for fibroid than average female would with the condition. Most fibroid do not cause any symptom, as some women never realize they have fibroid. In other women, uterine fibroid are discovered either during a routine gynecological examination. However, some women with fibroid may experience some symptoms, including abnormal vaginal bleeding or bleeding between periods. Here, the condition in most cases will be dictated during a routine pelvic examination. Gynecologists may feel fibroid in a woman, and several tests such as pelvic ultrasound or hysteroscopy and laparoscopy can confirm the diagnosis of fibroid. When fibroid is asymptomatic, no treatment is required. But in some cases, the condition may become dangerous or life-threatening or cause significant symptoms or are large enough to interfere with fertility. In such scenarios, treatment may be required, and several options for treating fibroid, both surgical and non-surgical methods, are available. We can confirm that abnormal vaginal bleeding could be caused by some natural processes like fibroid formation and unnatural processes such as introducing foreign bodies into the vagina. These circumstances will cause abnormal vaginal bleeding and are easily resolved. It is particularly important to be observant and seek medical help once there is concern. I hope the information in this video will support us as we care for our young children and grandchildren. I hope to see you next time when I will continue the discussion about abnormal vaginal bleeding. Thanks for watching, and please like and share this video to your friends and family, and I will see you soon.